Good morning, children. So let us start the new lesson, direct proportion and indirect proportion, inverse proportion, and it is also known as indirect proportion. Okay, now in the previous class we have learned how to compare two numbers and write them in the form of ratio. Now see, children, so we will compare two quantities by them subtracting them. Or what is ratio? Ratio means to compare the quantities by division. Okay, now let us see some examples, Sweta. See, children, this circle is divided by only one diameter. Okay. Now see, here we divide this circle by two diameters. Or you can divide this circle using four diameters. Now see, children, when you divide this circle by one diameter, so you will get two equal halves. Means, so it is A, this figure is B, this figure is C, and this figure is D. So one diameter makes dash parts of the circle. Two diameters and four diameters make gorilla in chapanna. Dash parts of the now observe the given figure and see, children, one diameter makes how many parts? Two parts. Okay. So what is the ratio of this? 1/2. Makes four parts. Three diameters makes six parts, and four diameters makes eight parts. Okay. Now, see, children. Two diameter makes four. Three makes six, and four makes eight. Okay, now see, children, after that, number of diameter divided by number of parts, or you can say division, number of parts. Now see children, here we will compare this by division. Okay, equals. Now see in figure A, it is 1/2. Okay, and which is equal to 2 diameters and 4 parts, which is equals to 3 diameters and 6 parts, and is equal to 4 diameters and 8 parts. Now see children, here the A is 1/2. If you reduce this fraction, so what you get? 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. It means it is also 1/2. 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. That means it is also equals to 1/2. 4 ones are 4, 4 twos are 8. Means again it is 1/2. Now see children, 1/2, 1/2, 1/2, 1/2. So here it remains constant. Okay, the ratio of the number, and it is what? Meter ratio. Ratio means what? Comparison by division. So here what we compare? Number of diameters and number of parts by division. So it is what, meter? Ratio. Now see children, here we will find the ratio of number of diameters and number of parts remains constant. Number of diameters to the number of parts remains constant. See, 1/2, 1/2, 1/2. Okay, so it is what, beta? When the ratio remains constant is what? Direct proportion. Now let us see the another question. The number of notebooks that the number of a government school received in a school. Now see, question is what, beta? The number of notebooks that the students of a government school received is shown in the table below. Okay, and children, and here notebooks. When number of children is 15, the number of notebooks is 19. When number of children are 12, it is 72 notebooks. 10, 16, and 5, 30. Now see, find the ratio of number of children to the number of books. So number of children to the number of notebooks. The number of notebooks. So see, we will say it is A, B, C, and D. So in A, it is 15/90, 12/72, 10/60, and it is 5/30. Now see children, we will reduce this fraction. Okay. 15/15. So it is 1/6. 12/12, 12/6. It is also 1/6. 10 ones are 10, 10 6. 1/6. 5 ones are 5. So it is. Now see children, their ratios are equal. Okay. So what we can say? So what we? What is the conclusion of this, see children? If here number of children are 15 and number of notebooks are 90. Now here we reduced, or you can say we will reduce it like this side. So in the B, number of children are reduced, so number of notebooks also reduced. Here also number of notebooks and number of children both are reduced. Okay, now see, if I increase number of children as 20, so how many notebooks are required? So here we multiply 5, 6. So how many notebooks are required for 20? 20. Okay, means, so here I increase the number of children, so number of notebooks are also increased. If you reduce one quantity, another quantity is automatically be increased. If you decreased one quantity, its related another quantity be automatically increased. So it is what, beta? It is direct proportion. Okay, means it is related to quantity. If you increase, and it's related whatever the things or rupees or whatever particulars are given, they automatically be increased. If you reduce one, another will be automatically be reduced. So it is what, direct. Okay, so let us see. So what is direct proportion? How we can define this? When two quantities X and Y are such that the ratio of X and Y remains constant. Remains constant means ek jaisa. Remains constant. Then we say X and Y vary directly. Means if the ratio between the quantities X and Y remains constant, we can say they are in the direct proportion. Directly. Got it, beta? So let's see some example on this direct proportion. The cost of 8 books
is rupees 72. Find the cost of 20 such books. Now see children, you can see this question is of unitary method, so you can solve it. Because it is unitary method, so you can solve this question by unitary method, or we can solve this question by like this. Suppose, see children, here we will make two columns, books and another column for cost. So see, 8 books cost rupees 72. So cost of 20 such books, so x. So what is x? X is used for unknown quantities. Okay, since it is the direct variation, so we will cross multiply. So you have to remember this thing, beta. In direct variation, you have to multiply cross. Okay, so 8 multiplied by x equals to 20 multiplied by 72. So x equals to, x means cost of 20 books. 20 multiplied by 72. Yes, and this multiplied by 8. So you have already learned in the simple linear equation. It is a simple linear equation. So to find the value of x, you have to move this multiplied by 8 from this left side, then it goes on right side. So it is divided by 8. 72 and 8. 8 ones are 8, 8 9s are. So what is left with us? 20 multiplied by 9. 9 twos are 80 and this 0. Okay, so it is what? Value of x. So the cost of 20 rupees, 20 books will be rupees 180. Cost of 180. Okay, so got it, beta? In this way, you can solve the questions on direct variation. Okay, so bye bye, children. Bye bye, beta.